Shri Mahaganapate Namaha, Shri Saraswati Namaha, Shri Padavallabha, Narasimha Saraswati, Shri Guru Dattatreya Namaha.
I am very grateful to Shri Prakash Rao Garu for providing me this opportunity with the divine blessings of Pujya Sri Ganapathy Sachchidananda Swamiji. I am fortunate enough to be here to receive the blessings along with all of you from Bhagavan Hanumanji and as well as Pujya Sri Swamiji. A small invocation and then we will commence the session. Gurur Brahma, Gurur Vishnu, Gurur Devo Maheshwaraha, Guru Sakshat Param Brahma, Tasmai Sri Gurave Namaha. The session at present is connected with one of the secret powers for success, which is for today, for this discussion, will be the power of belief, but which is connected to the subject matter in the Yoga Vasishta. So before we get into the talk, we will also offer the invocation as per the Yoga Vasishta. I request all of you to please repeat after me. Sarva Shakti Param Brahma. Sarva Vastumayam Tatam. Sarvada, Sarvatha, Sarvam, Sarvaihi, Sarvatra, Sarvagam, Sarvashakti Param Brahma. Sarva Vastumayam Tatam. Sarvada. Sarvatha Sarvam. Sarvaihi. Sarvatra Sarvagam. Sarvatra Sarvagam. Jai Guru Datta, Harihi Om. The very invocation gives us the most beautiful idea expressed in our spiritual tradition and spiritual culture. If we want to achieve anything, we need some kind of capability in us in order to achieve that. whatever might be the thing which we want to achieve, but we need some sort of capability. In other words, we need some power. I am not talking about the political power, which of course many people seek. But what I am talking about is the power which we need for achieving anything, gaining anything in life. And where is this power? What is this power? We may need various kinds of capabilities which are related to powers. Money also is a power. Influence is a power. Talent is a power. Like that, we need so many powers to get what we want to get, to gain what we want to gain, to experience and enjoy whatever we want to experience and enjoy. Are only few people gifted with the connectivity with the power, or everyone have equal opportunity and connectivity with the power? The idea expressed here is, whatever might be the various kinds of powers that are there in this manifested world, which all of us seek, but all these powers arise from the supreme source of all power. So what is that supreme source of all power? That is what here Sri Vasishtaji renders the invocation, Sarva Shakti Param Brahma. The all-powerful absolute reality. So the supreme source of all power is the absolute reality, which here is called as Param Brahma. That Parabrahma, which is the source for even the manifestation of Brahma, Vishnu and Maheshwara. They also have manifested from that supreme source of power. So that is why it is called as the all-powerful absolute reality. Without bringing the traditional terminology, we say it is absolute reality. Instead of calling it as Brahman or by any other terminological names, we say it is absolute reality. And where it is? Does anybody have its address? Is it on Facebook or YouTube or where it is available? Sarva Vastu Mayam Tatam. It is spread full of everything. If you and I are there, that all-powerful absolute reality is also spread in us, around us, outside us, inside us, above us, below us, everywhere. That means the accessibility is there for every one of us. None of us is specially privileged, or none of us is specifically deprived because of the eligibility criterion or any other criterion. So all of us are equally related to, connected with the supreme source of all power, the all-powerful absolute reality. And it also says, Sarvada, Sarvatha, Sarvam, Sarvaihi, Sarvatra, Sarvagam. It is everywhere, in everything, at all times. 24/7, 365 days. It's everywhere, in everything, at all times. If it is everywhere, in everything, at all times, now the responsibility is left with us to get connected. Like we have a computer or a laptop or a notebook or iPhone or whatever it is, or iPad 1 or 2, and if we get connected either through the SIM card or through wireless, then we have the connection with the whole world of information, with all kinds of websites. But we require some link which connects us. Even though we have the gadget, we have the instrument, we need that link. So first of all, we are trying to understand that the very invocation says, all of us are connected with that all-powerful absolute reality. When we are all connected with all-powerful absolute reality, then what? We have to invoke the power, the absolute reality, the power from the absolute reality, so that we become equipped with these unique powers, because of which we will be able to get whatever we want to get. Without those powers, we will not be able to achieve anything. But with those manifestations of the divine powers from the all-powerful absolute reality, we will be able to get everything. So the invocation itself says we are all equal. Equal in what? Equal in various ways. But here we are all equally connected with all-powerful absolute reality. And thereafterwards, we get into the topic for this evening. The main topic is the secret powers for success, because everybody wants success in whatever field they are, he or she is in. And the first one to go with is the power of belief. We might have heard these words many times: belief, faith, trust, and which are very important. Whether it is the field of karma yoga or bhakti yoga or dhyana yoga or raja yoga or whatever yoga or without yoga or bhoga, or even the attempt to get rid of roga. So we need some kind of understanding about this belief. Western world has one particular type of viewpoint towards belief. The Eastern world has another type of viewpoint towards belief. They go further into the belief and say faith, and then extend it still further and say it is trust. They don't stop at belief. They go more deeper into it. So the first statement, which is related to the power of belief, is human being can become anything. All of us are being told, or were told, or whenever possible will be told by others to become something. And we also impart the same thing to the children: you have to become something. And we were also told by others, you have to become something. So right from the tender age onwards, we will be planting these ideas in the children that become something great, become something mighty. So we all want to become something. If not anything, at least become happy, become peaceful. Successful, anyway we want to become. But there are people who are successful but not happy, successful but not peaceful. So we also want to become happy, become peaceful, become great, become noted, become popular, become a devotee, become blessed. It can be anything we want to become. So, sage Vasishta in the Yoga Vasishta says, human being can become anything. So he has already made the statement. It is not a political statement where statements are made, but they only don't mean what they are making. But it is a statement from the great master, the Rishi. Human being can become anything. And if they make a statement, they have to support it with a logic which we can understand, not which only they can understand. We also should understand. Statement is human being can become anything. So how it is supported? Because the world exists through thoughts and feelings. Whatever the world exists, whether it is in us, inside our mind, or outside us, the world exists only through thoughts and feelings. To put it in a simple way, we cannot experience the world, we cannot understand the world, we cannot know the world, we cannot gain any idea of the world without a thought or a feeling. Try. I want to know about you, but without a thought. It is not possible. Unless you become a thought in my mind, in the form of a thought, when you appear in my mind, I gain to know something about you, whether it is a fruit or a biscuit or a cookie or even a gold biscuit. If I want to know, then that particular object or a person or a thing has to become a thought in my mind. Then only I can know. That is why it is said, the world exists in the form of thoughts and feelings. We have feelings. So, let us go a little deeper into the word feel. Feel, F-E-E-L. Feel means to think, to believe. This is where the power of belief is connected with the feeling. To think, to believe. To have a particular opinion or an idea. We have so many opinions, so many ideas. To have a particular opinion or an idea is called as to feel. It also means to be strongly affected. Whether it is good or bad, when we are influenced by events or happenings or situations or incidents, we feel that we are under the impact of that particular event or situation or happening. Meaning what? Be strongly affected. So because of the feeling, we are strongly affected. So feel means that which makes us get strongly affected. To feel also means to become aware. To feel also means to be. It also means impression. Extend the word feel, it is feeling. Feeling means love, understanding, emotion, and empathy. All these are connected with the word feel or feeling. So, believing means that which is associated with the meanings of the word feel. Whatever we have seen just now, to feel, to think, to be strongly affected, to be, to become aware. So we become aware, but there is another quality to be, just to be. There is no need to become, but to be. To be itself is ultimate. Being in beingness, that's all, to be. Or otherwise to become. So all this is connected with the power of belief. Two friends were discussing between themselves. One of them asked the other, what do you mean by, or what do you understand by the word hypnotism? What do you understand by the word hypnotism? Then the other person said, I don't know much about it, but only have an opinion about it, an idea about it, that only I can say. He said, okay, please say whatever you know. Then he said, hypnotism is to control the mind of the other and to make him do whatever one wants the person to do. To control the mind of the other, to make him do whatever we want him to do. And that person said, oh, this is hypnotism. I thought this is marriage. So influencing and controlling the mind of the other and to make the person do whatever one wants to do. The idea here is, whatever we think, whatever we feel, whatever we become aware of, and whatever strongly influences or affects us, all these things have a great role to play in our life because they are all connected with the belief system we have. And belief is also connected with attitude because we have a particular attitude about anything and everything in this world. What is this attitude? Attitude is our feeling towards a fact or a condition. There is a fact. And there is a condition. And how we entertain our feeling towards that fact, towards that condition, is our attitude. Conditions are given. Facts are facts. There is a fact and there is a condition. How we feel about it, that decides about our attitude. If we have a very good feeling, then naturally our attitude will be good. We have a good attitude towards somebody, towards something. Naturally our behavior will be good. Our mannerism will be good. Our interaction will be good. Our expression will be good. Experience also will be good. Suppose we don't have a good feeling towards someone or something, then our attitude will not be good. And naturally, our behavior, our mannerism, our expression, our interaction will not be good. Then finally, the experience definitely will not be good. So, whenever we get such an experience, instead of throwing the blame on the event or happening or incident or the other person, saying that such and such a person or event or happening or incident is responsible for this experience, we need to understand that what is actually causing that is my feeling towards that condition, my feeling towards that fact. If I understand that these feelings can be influenced by myself, if I can influence that feeling and change my feeling towards a fact or a condition, then I can also change the experience. What I am going to gain or what I am getting. So attitude is our feeling towards a fact or a condition. And what determines this attitude? Attitude is determined by very important connection. Meaning the whole responsibility is on our hands only. Attitude is determined by what we think, what we say, and what we do. What we think, what we say, and what we do. We are constantly either thinking or saying or doing. If we are not doing, we are at least saying. If we are only saying and not doing, at least we are thinking. Thinking is going on. So what we think, what we say, and what we do, that determines the attitude. And attitude is again a feeling towards a fact or a condition. So what is that which is creating these attitudes, which are also influencing these feelings? It is what we say, what we think, what we do. That is all it is. I have heard about a very nice discussion that happened between two people. One was from Mumbai and another one was from Delhi, New Delhi. So the person from New Delhi was talking about the hardship which is undergoing because of the heavy rush in the transport system. During those days, there was no metro rail system in New Delhi, so there was only buses which were mostly utilized for commuting from one place to another. So this person from New Delhi was telling about his hardship and he said, "See, I am really facing a very difficult situation. Once it so happened that I had to attend an interview for a better job and I boarded the bus and I wore the dress also. I ironed the dress, especially my shirt, and I got into the bus. So much of rush. It is overcrowded. And by the time I got out of that bus, my shirt was full of wrinkles. It lost its shape. And with that shirt, when I attended the interview, that man said, your dress also is not looking proper. And your mind also is an indication of your dress. So you are not at all considered for interview. So I feel so bad about this. What can I do? I don't have any private transport. And this is what is troubling me a lot. I get into the bus and my shirt gets wrinkled. And then I feel very bad about it. And the other person from Mumbai said, what do you know about Bombay? Especially our trains, local trains. All that you need to do is simply stand on the platform. You don't need to put any effort to get into the train. You simply stand. But see to it that you stand on the right platform. And that also at the right time when the right train arrives. The moment the local train arrives, you will be freely taken into the train compartment. Effortlessly, you will be transported. Because everybody will push. Easily, you will get into it. And it is so crowded, so crowded. That also is crowded. And even to come out also, all that you need to do is stand at the exit. You will be taken out. That is all it is. And he said, I wear a wrinkled shirt and I get into it. By the time I get out of it, because of that rubbing and then scrubbing and all that, the shirt becomes ironed, perfectly ironed. Because of that warmth generated because of body contact also. It is totally cleanly ironed. It becomes perfect. Two people in similar situations having two different attitudes. Almost the same situation. One person is feeling very bad about it. Another person is feeling very good about it. Situation almost is the same. Whether it is bus or a train, same situation. But it all depends upon the attitude that one has. So attitude is connected with what? The feeling. What is that? It is a feeling towards a fact or a condition. It is a fact, a given fact. That is what is the transport system there. Condition is like that. It is given. You can't change that condition or a fact. But how we feel about it is important. And how this attitude is determined? Determined by what we think, what we say, and what we do. That is all it is. So, if a particular fact or a condition or a situation is bothering us, troubling us, irritating us, frustrating us, weighing heavily upon us, what we need to do? Generally, we struggle to change the situation or a fact or a condition. That is why it's the problem. We can't change that, but we want to change that. Because we think that is the only way out of it. So we always put efforts to change the fact, change the condition, change the situation, or at least change the person. Are we successful in that? We are not. Not always, and not many times also. Rarely, we may be, but not always. So then what will happen to us? Our attitude leads us into negative feeling. That is what happens. That is why we feel bad about facts, events, situations, conditions. So that is why here it is said, if we train ourselves in thinking correctly, saying what is right, and doing what is noble and divine, then automatically the feelings are taken care of, thoughts, words, deeds are taken care of. We will have right attitude, which is filled with right feelings. And when we have right attitude and right feeling, naturally our belief system will be very powerful. With that powerful belief system, definitely we will achieve or attain very good success. So, continuing further, we move on to the next point. Believing means to think that it is possible, to feel that it is certain, to feel that it is certain, to think that it is possible. We have to think it is possible. You have to feel it is certain. That is how the belief gets formed, gets strengthened. And it is also said, because we are combining the ideas from the Western world and the Eastern world, it is also said, believing means to draw a mental blueprint. Mental blueprint. Mentally. Not on paper. That is the thing that follows later, but mental blueprint, and hold on to it and focus the total attention of mind upon it. Draw a mental blueprint of what we want to become, what we want to be, what we want to achieve, what we want to gain, what we want to experience. Draw a mental blueprint of it and then hold it in our mind and focus the total attention upon it. When we do that, what happens is, in this present state, what looks impossible, because nothing is there, only we are trying to draw a mental blueprint, becomes possible. What is impossible becomes possible. This building, this Hanumanji's Mandir, it was in the form of a sankalpa in Pujya Shri Swamiji's mind. Thereafterwards, it was given to the devotees and sevaks. So then what they did? They also took it and then held it in the mind and then focused their attention and started working for it. So along with the grace and blessings, with the effort, then what happens? What was not there here, what was not existent here, became existent. And what is not visible there also will become visible very soon. It will become existent because all the efforts are being made to motivate the people towards it. That also is in the form of a blueprint now. Later on, it will become a reality. So what is in the form of a blueprint now, in this present state, it is not possible. It is not there. It is not there to be seen. It is not there to be visualized or experienced. That is the state. But it becomes possible. So what is impossible becomes possible. How is it possible? If we hold it in the form of a blueprint in our mind and focus all the attention on it towards it. Now that is what is connected to believing. How nice it is. That is why it is also said, faith little bit extended. If we extend the belief, it goes into the faith. Shraddha. It is more related to good understanding that we have in our intellect about a particular thing. When we hold it, when we do the dharana or understanding, when we gain understanding of it in our intellect, naturally we will gain something of it. It becomes very steady in our mind. So faith is to believe what we do not see. And the reward or result is we see what we believe. Faith is to believe what we do not see. But the reward is we see what we believe. But we have to start with that. So that is what is believing is all about. And it is also said to dream, imagine, visualize whatever we want to dream, imagine, and visualize is the creative beauty of our mind. If we have to dream, if we have to imagine, if we have to visualize, what we think, what we say, what we do should be in proper synchrony. If we don't have these three things in synchrony, then our attempt to visualize a particular thing, dream about it, will not be possible because it will be halted there only. Because of the conflict inside between what we think, what we say, and what we do, and whatever we want to dream or imagine or visualize will not be continued further. It will not be in a progressive state. Because of the conflicts inside, conflict between what we think and what we say, conflict between what we say and what we do, and conflict between what we do and what we think, whether before it or after it. So there is conflict. Everything is fragmented. It is split. So because of this, if we want to dream, imagine, and visualize whatever we want to become, that will also not be in a progressive state because it will be halted. It will be broken. It will be into bits and pieces. So that is why what we think and what we say and what we do are very important. There has to be synchrony. I have heard that during the time of elections, one political leader went for canvassing, talking to people about why he has to be voted to power, why people have to vote for him. So he went and started knocking the doors and then meeting people and telling them, please vote for me, please vote for my party. Generally, people don't want to extend the talk with such people, so they say, okay. And there was one person who said, how can I do that? Huh? And this man was surprised. I am asking you to vote for my party. That means vote for me. And you say, how can I do that? Are, what happened to you? Why you are not able to do that? And that man said, yesterday another politician belonging to another political party came and then asked me to vote for him. Then I promised it to him that I will vote for him. Then how can I do that? How can I do it now? How can I vote for you? And that politician said, oh, your promise. In politics, is there any need to fulfill the promises? Don't bother about this fulfillment of promise. This is politics, man. Don't bother about it. You are not bound by your promise towards that politician. Look at my credentials. and what I am going to do for you. Look at all these promises. And don't look at that. Look at this and then tell me, are you going to vote for me? I said, if that is the case, I will vote for you. So what is the case? You need not fulfill your promise. Who is telling that? This politician is. And then what is saying? Now, can you vote for me? I say, yes. If that is the case, yes, I will vote for you. Meaning what? He is not sure whether I will vote or not. He is just making a statement. And the politician also is not sure because he only created the conflict in the mind of the voter. What did he create? You need not do what you say. Conflict created. And then he is asking you, say now. To me, you say whether you will vote or not. So, what the politician says and does is a conflict. Same thing he is teaching the voter. He is also in a conflict. When both are in conflict, what is the guarantee? What is the surety? There is no guarantee. So, what we think, what we say, and what we do not only affects us. If the other person is not strong, it influences the other person also. Then what happens? The people who are in a conflicting state of mind will form as a group and then they will create more conflicts. That is all it is. Earlier it was individual contribution of conflict. Now it will be group contribution of conflict, free contribution. The other people will have it because of this conflict. So that is why this believing is not simply dreaming, not simply imagining, not simply visualizing. A character is associated with that dreaming, imagining and visualizing. That is why we depend more upon the strength of the character also which is inside. If that character is firm, then what happens? What we think, what we say, what we do is properly connected and related. It is one and the same. Then belief system will become strong. Then the faith will become strong. Then certainly what is impossible also becomes possible. And it is also said to trust the divine, to trust the guru, to trust the spiritual master, to trust the divine, to trust the God, all these are included in it. To trust the divine is to receive the grace and blessings of the divine. So we normally say we want to receive the grace and blessings of the divine guru and the divine God. We want to receive the grace and blessings. But Vasishthaji says, how do we receive that grace and blessings? To trust the divine. That is very important. Our part is to trust the divine. Belief has grown into faith and that has become trust now. When there is no iota of doubt, then it becomes trust. A belief can be shaken. That is why people say, I believed in that person so much and he let me down. I thought he will take me up and then let me down. So belief can be shaken. Faith, if it is not reinforced with spiritual understanding and scriptural understanding, it also may tend to bend. Faith also. That is why sometimes the faithful people will fool themselves and others also. But when it becomes trust, there is no looking back. There is no turning back. Once it has become trust, it is completely in surrender and acceptance. There is nothing more left. So the trust, to trust the divine is to receive the grace and blessings of the divine. If you trust the divine, automatically we are receiving the grace and blessings of the divine. And it is also said very nicely, divine, D-I-V-I-N-E. If we look into the alphabets, then we can come to this understanding. E stands for effectively. Effectively, D, dream, I, imagine, V, visualize. Effectively, dream, imagine, visualize. In D-I-V-I-N-E, if we take away E, D, I, V, and we are left with I and N. So, to effectively dream, imagine, visualize inside, I-N. To effectively dream, imagine, visualize inside is divine, is trusting the divine. So, this is very good understanding about what is divine, how to become really divine in our expressions, how to really gain the grace and blessings of the divine in manifestation through us so that we achieve whatever we want to achieve and gain what we want to gain. It is in this manner. So that we trust the divine and the divine is with us and we are certain to gain it. I have heard that once a person applied for the post of an attendant in a city in India, for example, Bengaluru, that city. One person applied for the post of an attendant. It was a government job, but attendant. Where? Attendant at a public toilet. So that only was the thing that was possible for him to apply for, so he applied. And there, the officer who was there to receive that application, he rejected that application and threw that application on the face of the person. Because this fellow did not know how to fill in that application and he did not know how to sign. So that was one of the eligibility criteria on there. At least he should be having a certificate of pass in 10th standard or 10 plus 2, at least minimum that is. He was not having that also, illiterate person. So he was rejected. The situation is rejection. He had that only hope for the job. Now the situation is he was rejected. Now then what happens? He can get into depression. He can feel lost. He can consider himself as a failure. And then he can feel that nothing is going to happen in my life. And there are people like that. Suddenly something happens to their mind and then they become like that. So he could have gone that way, but he did not go that way because he had a belief in himself and he had trust in the divine. So what he did, instead of feeling lost, instead of losing hope, instead of condemning himself and becoming gloomy and not having any brightness in the mind or enthusiasm, but what he tried to do is he started contemplating upon what to be done. Then he went to his friend, then borrowed some amount from him. Then he went to a vegetable market, purchased some vegetables in the market, farmer's market, and then he also purchased a basket, placed those vegetables in that basket, and went around in the colonies where people live, in the localities or subdivisions, whatever you may call it, where people live, and tried to sell them to the people. And because he carried the fresh vegetables and good quality, people purchased them. Next day again went. Then again people started liking the quality and the mannerism and the attitude and the cheerfulness in the person, how he talks, how he communicates, how he respects. They started buying. After a couple of months, he left the basket. Now he got a cart, vegetable cart, push cart, and started selling them. More number of people started buying. Then he left that cart. Now what he did is he got a nice shop for himself and he started a vegetable shop where he started selling the vegetable. Then people, because they are good and he is good, they started going to him. After one and a half years, 18 months, then he got so much of money that he started 2 or 3 more shops at different localities and provided employment for others also. Then after 5 years, he became so popular, he had a huge network in many cities in India that people from USA, the business houses from USA thought, here it is all credit and credit and credit and no immediate returns. So they thought India is a good market. So they wanted to venture into a business in the vegetable field, vegetable market. So they knew about this person and they wanted to get into a contract, sign up a contract with this person, international contract. So they went and then a team of members went and spoke to the person. Then it was finalized. Then all of them went to the bank. And in the bank, the manager was so happy that this man was already famous because of his chain stores of vegetable markets. So he was very much willing to give loan. And then he had to sign on the bank that application documents or whatever bank documents they are. So when the bank manager asked him to sign, he said, he smiled and he took out a stamp pad and with his thumb, and then he placed his thumb at the place where he said signature or thumb impression. But now, in olden days, you know, the people who give thumb impression, they used to be treated as a third-rated people. But now, what are we doing at the immigration and all thumb impressions only, you know? That is the most intelligent way to connect with the people. You know? The same thing has come into the first level now. If you sign, it is not accepted. People don't accept your signature because anybody can sign. Thumb impression, nobody can duplicate it. So that is what it is. Now the Angota chap is the most respectable chap. Angota chap. So that is what it is. So when he took out that stamp pad and said, he placed his thumb impression there, bank managers were stunned. Without any education, if you could become so great, what if you had education, what else you could have become? He said that. That man immediately said, attendant at a public toilet. I could have become attendant at a public toilet. Had I been qualified at that time, I would have been satisfied with that. That doesn't mean we should not get educated. That is not my point. The point is how we look at an incident or an event. If our belief system, if our faith, if our trust are perfect in us, then whatever might be the external situation or condition, with the trust in the Guru, with the trust in the Divine, we can go ahead and we can really achieve whatever we want to achieve in spite of all odds and all difficult situations outside us or around us. So meaning what? That much of power is there in us. If we invoke the power from the Divine, like when Pooja Sri Swamiji says, if we believe it and if we simply trust it and do it, everything will happen. Because what we cannot see, the great masters can see. And what they see, we don't see. Right now, we don't see. But we will come to see. We will certainly see. Because certainly it is going to happen. So right now, what we have to do, we have to believe it. We have to have faith in it. We have to trust it. That is all. Once we trust, then the grace and the blessings of the Divine will start flowing into us. We are not capable of it. We are not eligible to achieve it or capable of gaining it. But because of the grace and blessings of the Guru, of the Master, of the God flow into us, we get that eligibility criterion. We meet that eligibility criterion. Because we become a channel for the grace and blessings to flow through us, and then whatever is supposed to be done, it will be done through us. Because we have accepted it, because we have trusted it, then we will receive all that is supposed to receive. And another very beautiful statement Vasishthaji says is, the power of consciousness manifests in us, meaning in all of us, as the power of being and the power of becoming. These are two things, two powers, power of being, power of becoming. After all becoming, one became great and then got a good job and a lot of money, and then instead of one house has 10 houses, and then a lot of influence, lot of popularity, got so much of great social status and so many positions there also, awards, rewards, and naturally eligible awards also, and fabricated awards, whatever it is, all the person has got. Now what? After that, after all that strings of success, after all that becoming, now that person wants to be in peace. There are so many people who achieve everything. Afterwards, they feel, what is that now I have? I have everything, but I still feel that there is something that is missing. So for such people, they have to know how to manifest the power of being. You have to be now. Enough of becoming. You have to be. But there are people who have not started the journey only. Then for them to be means to just become lazy, to while away the time, to waste all the opportunities. For such people, power of be is not to be manifested. Power of becoming. They have to become, do this, do that, gain that, achieve this, achieve that, become this, become that. Afterwards, be. After all that becoming is done, you have satisfied yourself with all kinds of achievements, then what? Still the life will be empty because we have not manifested the power of being. The power of being is the ultimate one. The power of becoming also is very important. Only when we manifest the power of becoming, then we will be able to experience the power of being also. Manifestation. So, when you go to God, when you go to the great master, do they want to become anything? No, they have already become whatever they have to become. God is, God just is. And even for that matter, Pujya Sri Swamiji is, that's all. You and I want to become something. That is why we come here. We want to become something. So by receiving the grace and blessings from the God and the Guru, we become something. But what the Guru want to become? Nothing. Maybe Guru wants to be more happy by seeing the children, by seeing the devotees, by seeing the disciples become more and more happy and more successful. That is all it is. That is the only thing that a Guru wants. That is the only thing that God wants. When we go and meet the God, God just is. When you go to God, have you ever seen the God telling you something? Complaining to you about something? Showing frustration? Have you ever seen God? See, all our gods, images of gods are smiling. Have you ever seen any God like this? Have you ever seen any God? Never you will see like that. Because all are smiling. That also, Vasishthaji says very nicely, Chit Shaktir Brahmano Rama Sharire Svabhidrushyate Spanda Shaktis Chavateshu Jada Shaktis Tadhopale Drava Shaktis Tadambasu Teja Shaktis Tadhanale Shunya Shaktis Tadhakase Bhava Shaktir Bhavasthitau. It is a beautiful sloka from sage Vasishta in the Yoga Vasishta, which is connected with the power of consciousness, how it manifests. See, Chit Shaktihi Brahmano Rama Sarireshvabhi Drushyate. The power of consciousness, O Rama, manifests in this body, manifests in this world, manifests even in this body also, manifests in this world also. So body at individual level is individual's body, at the total level is the total gross body, which is the total world, total gross world. So, the power of consciousness manifests in our bodies. How? That is very important. So, we can understand when we look outside, what are all the mighty things? Spanda shaktischa vateshu, meaning the power of motion in the wind. Wind moves. And not only that it moves, it has the power of motion. It also moves things along with it, especially here. With all powerful winds, what will happen? It can blow away anything also. It can blow away anything. So, whether it is twisters or whatever it is, they blow away everything. Meaning what? The power of motion in the wind. But this power of motion in the wind can be properly tapped and converted as a source of power. There are so many people who tap this source and then convert into a source of power through windmills. We have seen windmills, and through that they convert this power of motion in the wind into a power which can be utilized by us. So what manifested as this power of motion in the wind? The power of consciousness. And jada shaktis tadhopale, in a stone there is the power of inertness. That is why if we make an idol in a stone with a smiling face, it will ever remain smiling. Today it is smiling, tomorrow when we come back, it is not angry, frowning, sad. It is not, because that remains as it is. And not only that, if we place it there, it remains there only. If we come tomorrow, it is not somewhere else. Otherwise, it has become very tough for us. Then our whole day will end up in chasing God, our deity. So it will remain there only. That is the power, that also is the power of inertia in solid things. They remain there, that's all. Suppose we are sitting on this carpet, this remains here only. That's why we can also remain. Suppose it starts moving, then what will happen? So, that also is a power. And then, drava shaktistadhambasu, in water there is power of liquidity. Those people who understand the power of liquidity, they utilize it in various ways. To quench the thirst also, to tap the electricity in water also, and through the principle of flotation, through use it as a transporting medium also, they use the water as various ways and then for their benefit. So all that power is again a manifestation of the power of consciousness. Teja shakti sthadhanale. Teja shakti. The power of heat and light in the fire. We use that power of heat in the fire. Tejas, heat. For cooking the food also. For warming ourselves also. For keeping the home warm also. Various ways we use that power. So, in the fire. So, that also is a power. What is that power actually? What is the source of that power? The power of consciousness only has manifested as the power of heat in fire. And shunya shakti stadha akashe. In akasha, there is power of nothingness, shunya, emptiness. Because there is power of emptiness, we can occupy. Akasha means that which gives us avakasha to occupy it. It gives an opportunity to occupy. That's why we occupied this space. We all occupied this space in the hall. Because there is space in the hall, that is why we occupied. That is what is akasha. Akasha is that. So, the power of emptiness in akasha. We all understand these five powers of the five elements. Earth, water, fire, air and ether. You have understood now, space. Now, the same power, power of supreme consciousness, which has manifested all these various powers in these mighty elements, also manifests in us. Manifests in us as bhava shaktir bhava sthitau. In this world, we are in this world, it manifests in us as the power of being and the power of becoming. How beautiful it is. So if we want to be, we can be. Whatever might be the situation around us, if we want to be in peace, we can be. That is what is power of being. If we want to be with Guru, we can be with the Guru. If we want to be at the feet of the Guru, we can be at the feet of the Guru. If we want to be with God, we can be with God being. Not always doing. We need to know the being also. If we combine these two things in a day, the power of being also, the power of doing also, the power of becoming also, then we are said to be really successfully manifesting the powers inside us. So that we can really become successful. So the power of being and the power of becoming. So we need not have any doubt about these things. From where these powers are manifested in us? From the power of supreme consciousness only. The all-powerful absolute reality manifests in both of us as the power of being also and the power of becoming also. So if you want to become anything, we need not be bogged down by comments from others, criticism from others, opinions from others, that you cannot become, you cannot achieve, you cannot do this, you cannot do that, you are not fit for it, you are not capable of that. There are people who dump these ideas and thoughts into us. If we accept those things, then what happens? We will become conditioned by these things and we also think, yes, we can't do, yes, we are not capable, yes, we are not, yes, and we will become dull. But that is the time where we have to understand the teaching of Sage Vasishta and we have to draw that inspiration from there that we have the power of becoming inside us. The power is not ours. The power is the power of consciousness which has manifested in us. It is available inside us. All that we need to do is to tap and connect with it. That is all we need to do. There was one student, a little student, who came to the class and then who sat in the class. The teacher was teaching something. And suddenly the student got up and said, "Teacher, are you going to punish me for what I have not done?" Then the teacher said, "What do you think of me? Why will I punish you for what you have not done? If you have not done any mischief, if you have not done any wrong thing, if you have not troubled anybody, if there is nothing that you have done, why will I punish you? I assure you that I am not going to punish you for what you have not done." He asked, "Are you sure, teacher?" "Yes, I am not going to punish you for what you have not done." Then he said, "I have not done the homework." Now it is left to the teacher to decide. Because I have already made a statement. See, the statements that are there in the Yoga Vasishta are the statements not from an unevolved being or an ordinary being. They are from the great Rishi who has experienced that all-powerful absolute reality in himself. And he knows that he is not different from that all-powerful consciousness. So, he made that statement to whom? Who was the student of Vasishta? Sri Ramachandraji was the student of Vasishta. Who is the ultimate God for our Hanumanji here also? So all the power of Hanumanji actually is the power of Sri Rama only. The name of Sri Rama, the form of Sri Rama. Because Hanumanji also says, somebody asked, what is the secret of your success? Some journalist might have gone and asked. So Hanumanji also said, I don't have any secret of success. The only secret is Rama Nama and Rama Rupa. That is all it is. Always my mind is at his feet. Always my tongue is chanting his name. That is all it is. Similarly, if we also place the divine name of the Guru and the God on our tongue and in our heart and mind, then definitely we will also get all the powers from them. And then we become a channel. So they will be channelized through us and we will achieve it. That is what Sage Vasishthiji also said. So if we are disturbed, if we are frustrated, if we are agitated, if we are confused, and if we are unable to get out of it, at least at that time we have to understand. Vasishthiji has said that we have power of being also. We can be in peace, we can be in stability, we can be in steadiness, we can be in firm, resolute, one-pointedness, we can be in calmness. So we have to invoke that. So we have to immediately invoke that power. We have to remind ourselves, we have to recollect ourselves that we need to invoke this power of becoming, power of being. So both are there inside us. So next time, whenever we get a thought, I don't know how to handle the situation, I don't know how to gain that, we need to understand that both these things are really there inside us. The proof for this is Yoga Vasishta itself, in the words of Sage Vasishta, that we have the power of being inside us, the power of becoming inside us. The one who has got deeply into the power of being doesn't want to achieve anything. No name, no fame, no profit, no sense pleasure, nothing one wants. What one wants? The one who has understood, one who is one with that power of consciousness, one who is one with that consciousness itself, the very pure Brahmic consciousness itself, what does that person want? He is only manifesting that gracefulness and blessedness through his living, through his being, through his functioning. Om Shantihi, Shantihi, Shantihi.
To conclude with the blessings of Puja Swamiji, that whatever we have seen now from the wisdom of Yoga Vasishta, in the words of Sage Vasishta,
that we need to trust the divine to receive the grace and blessings of the divine. Individually, we might have certain thoughts, certain belief systems, which might be functioning as obstacles or as hurdles, and we might see the external situations and incidents and events and happenings, and we may feel that we are not capable of handling it, or we are not eligible to come out successful in overcoming it. At that time, we have to recollect the ideas that are given to us by Sage Vasishta, that whatever teaching he has given to Sri Ramachandraji, that the power of consciousness has manifested inside us, is available inside us, as the power of being and as the power of becoming. So if you want to become anything, we can become that by exercising the power of belief and converting it into faith, and finally taking it into the state of trust, where there is absolute surrender and total acceptance of whatever the guru says, whatever the spiritual master says, and whatever the guidance that has come from the guru, and then whatever the God has given to us in the form of teaching. When we completely trust it, then after we trust it, then we have nothing else to do there. As we have already recollected, that we have to draw a mental blueprint of what we want to become and hold it and focus our mind on it, and then invoke all the grace and blessings and all the power from the guru and from the God. When we invoke that, even though we are individually incapable of handling the situation or achieving the success, we will gain that capability and eligibility. All the powers will be manifested through us, in us, for giving us whatever we want to gain. So that is what Vasishthiji also said in conclusion, that let us at any point of time understand that we have only one thing, that the Sadguru doesn't want actually anything from us. Because he is one with the consciousness, he is nothing different from the Brahmic consciousness. He is that Parabrahman. So when he is not different from Parabrahman, what Sadguru wants is nothing for himself. What the Sadguru wants is everything for others. Like Puja Sri Swamiji, always he is wishing and willing the well-being of others and the success of others. So if we want that, we can draw this from the great Mahapurusha and the God himself. So when we trust the divine, we receive the grace and blessings of the divine. When we become a channel for the grace and blessings of the divine to flow through us to the world around us, then we are certain to get whatever we want to get. Then we realize the statement that faith is to believe what we do not see, and the reward is we see what we believe. So may we all believe, may we all have faith, may we all have trust at the feet of Puja Sri Swamiji and the God that Puja Sri Swamiji shows to us as our presiding deity, and may we all be blessed and become successful. So this is what we thought about the power of belief in connected with secret powers for success. Tomorrow, with the blessings of Puja Sri Swamiji, we will see about another such power from the Yoga Vasishta. Om Shantihi, Shantihi, Shantihi.